it was difficult. There was some crying involved. There was a lot of heated discussion with myself, yes. These are just the ones that are a little bit extra, like me. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video where I'm going to talk about palettes that made me do a double take, because they are the most unique that I have in my collection. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you want to learn how to be fabulous in your 40s, or maybe you already are fabulous, like me. If you want to be entertained, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, and maybe most importantly, if you are slightly orcish, like me, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. Yes, let me explain the slightly orcish. It's basically light olive, or olive in general. So if you are olive, you're slightly orcish. That's the gist of it. That's how my son calls us, very, very lovingly. This video is not thought of by me. I saw Beauty and the Frizz do it, and I will leave her channel down below. When I started pulling palettes, I found out that I have a lot more interesting color stories than I thought I would have. I did give myself criteria though, because I ended up with, I don't know, 30 palettes that I pulled. And I was like, no, you need to bring it down. You need to choose. So I was like, okay, now you need to choose one per brand. That's the maximum. So I cannot have 3 or 4 or 2 whatever per brand. No, just one. I ended up with these 15, and that's not to say that I don't love all my palettes, because I do, and I have a lot of interesting color stories in my collection. These are just the ones that are a little bit extra, like me. Let's start with the one that I have here, which is an older palette. I have older palettes and I have newer palettes. Let's just start with this one. It's the Made by Mitchell palette, the Feet on the Ground. You will hear me say a lot, interesting color story. Please don't take a shot every time I say it's a unique color story or whatever. Need I say more though? It's just so, so interesting. And the same thing with the other one that he came out with as well. What was it? Head in the Clouds was also a very, very interesting color story. This just spoke to me a little bit more. And the quality is very, very nice as well. What can I say? I'm very curious to see what else he comes up with. But this is just... You would think it's quite a normal color story, but it's not. With the coral and then the dark purple, the teal. Yeah, what can I say? It's a unique color story. Please don't drink when I say that, every time I say that. Let's next go to a palette that when this was released, I was like, oh, that is so interesting. I need it. It's the Starry Night palette from Storybook Cosmetics. This color story... Yeah, what do I need to say it? You know, it's just, yes, you have blues, but there's also a yellow, a green, an orange. And that just that makes it so, so, so interesting. And it's also the complete vibe. Now, quality wise, I think this is my least favorite. Yeah, this is my least favorite that I have here. If you are a beginner, I don't think this is a palette that you would like, unless you really want to go for what it stands for. It was a little bit difficult to work with, but yeah, what can I say? It's very, very unique. That's what the video is about, not how much I love something, because some of my favorites did not make this video. Yeah, and it was so, so sad. We are kind of going to go through that right now. So the next palette that I have, it's just... When I show it to you, I think you'll understand why I picked it. However, it was split. I had 2 palettes of this brand, but I was only allowing myself to use one. The reason why this palette won is because this one is still available. Let's go with that. And it's from Kaleidos. This is the Flowerpunk palette. Now, need I say more? So yes, the other palette that I had pulled was the Club Nebula, but that one isn't available anymore. So, and that's also a unique color story. I just feel this one is a little bit... I don't want to say that the Club Nebula is more generic, because it's not. It's just that this combination, these specific tones combined in this palette, and then with the artwork and the way that it opens, everything makes it just such a unique palette that it's in this video. Yeah. Next, I'm going to go to, I don't think, no, it's not a drugstore brand. I think it's, is it an, I don't know. It's drugstore pricing though. It's from Beauty Bay and it's the Wilderness palette. Again, need I say more? It's so, so interesting. You can do basically a summery oceany vibe look. You can do a fall look. You can do a bang on red. You can do so much with this palette. The quality is so, so nice as well. It's, I think that this is very, very unique to the market. Yeah. And also very unique for Beauty Bay themselves. And the quality is very, very nice. I'm so happy that I have this in my collection. Then the next palette is a palette that is from a brand that has, that's known for their unique color stories. Or at least for me it is. It's a palette that I did get this one in PR. And I had to choose between this one and another one. This one won. And I will explain why it won. And it is Nomad Cosmetics USA Parks. Now, I was debating between this one and the Iceland palette. And this one won. Why? Because of the shimmers that are in here. So I really love the color story. And the color story may look very, very nice and normal for you until you look deeper. So this shade, for instance, is a yellow with that brick red shimmer and a hint of green. This one has this one as a base, but also has a little bit of yellow. It also has a little bit of green. Then this shade is a little bit more shiny, but I don't know. Can you see what it is doing? I hope I can kind of show it. Probably not. They are just all so, so unique. This shade is the purple and the green, but also has a hint of green. Brown, not green. This one is a teal, but it is actually a blue with a green shift in it. You can do very nice everyday looks, but you can also really spruce it up. And just because of the shimmers and the duochrome things that she did in here, it's just such a unique color story. Yes. The next palette that I'm going to mention is from VE Cosmetics and it's the Blood Moon palette. Can we just also, you know? All her palettes are very, very special, but this one, color story wise, I don't know, I feel is the most special. Why? Because it's also an all matte palette. It's the only all matte palette that I have in my collection. And then the colors, the quality. This was a palette that when it was sneaked, I was like, I know I'll need it. And that's what makes a special palette for me. And also, yeah, the color story, look at how cool the color story is. Honestly, if you like matte eyeshadows, or if you want to try anything from VE Cosmetics and you don't know what to get, this, chef's kiss, yes. The next palette I'm going to go to is Drugstore. And maybe it's not really unique on the market, but it is very, very unique in my collection. And that's the Paris, the Passion in Paris from BH Cosmetics. Why do I say it may be not very unique to the market? Because it kind of reminds me a little bit of the Muerte palette from Melt, but that one is no longer sold. But in my collection, this is very, very unique. And I feel like it's very unique for BH Cosmetics as well. And the quality, oh, honestly, very, 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 very cool. You can go very, very deep and dark and grungy. You can go a little bit more lighter, a little bit more everyday. Yeah. Yeah, and in my particular collection, it's very unique as well. Next, I'm going to go to Alien Cosmetics. And this is a palette that I did pay for, but I do have an affiliate code. And I have more codes that will all be listed down below in the description box. This is the Fairy Frolic. Now, this is one of her first palettes, I believe. She has revamped it, though, because the artwork that she has in the newer palettes is new. And the pans are not round anymore. They are square. She has also reformulated. So I'm very curious to see how it will hold up against this one. I really want to order the new Fairy Frolic to see how it will compare to this one. Yeah. Again, very, very unique. The mattes are, these are the mattes and the rest are shimmers. Oh no, I'm lying. Yeah, no, I did. Yeah, that, no. That's the mattes. this looks like a dark brown on camera, but it's actually a very, very deep plum. which makes it not the most easiest color story to work with, at least I feel, because if I want to blend it into the yellow, because of the undertones of the two specific shades, it's a little bit more difficult. So I have to pull in the green first, or maybe even that one. But yeah, color story itself, it's very, very unique. Yeah. Okay. Oh, my back is hurting a lot. Okay, let's next go to Odin's Eye Cosmetics. And from Odin's Eye Cosmetics, I have quite a bit of palette here. There are more that have a uniquer color story, but this one for me is the most unique that I have from them. And that's the Norns, the big Norns palette from the Norns collection. I actually think that this color story is just unique to the entire, to the market. And that's pretty hard to do, right? Because there is so much makeup coming out. And then for a brand to still be able to make unique color stories, that's saying something. I'm very, very fortunate that I'm on their PR list now. I don't have a code with them because they only have affiliate codes, and yeah, I don't have one. But this one I did pay for, and it's just, yeah, again, a very, very, very unique color story. I love the brand. I love the whole aesthetic. Next, I'm going to go to an Australian indie brand, and that is Lucky Bunny Cosmetics, and it's their Envy, it's her Envy palette. It's the first palette that she launched, and when I saw this palette, I was like, oh, that is so, so interesting. I'm gonna need that. It's this one. It's her Greed. Is it Greed or is it Envy? Envy palette. So, I love green eyeshadow, and it is a green palette, and that this one is in there is not really weird. These three. That's what makes it so unique. I've not seen another palette, at least not when this launched, that has those grays and the purple in combination with the green. So basically you can do, you can go green or you can go a very, very different route if you want to. And the quality is very, very nice. I do have an affiliate code with her as well. Okay, let's next go to check outside a little. Oh my God. The next palette is from Colourpop, and it's pretty, it's a thing, isn't it, for Colourpop to be able to be unique, because they are duping themselves very much so right now. At least the palette that I pulled, it's the Baroque, because I, not only in my own collection it's very unique, but I also feel that it's very unique for Colourpop. Those bluer grays, and then yeah, those brownies in, I don't know, it's just, I feel it's just very, very unique color story altogether, and I really, really like the quality. Yeah. Okay, next. Very loud car. Next is a palette that was a collab between Bute Bean and Shroud. Do I need to say? Yes, it's also very much my color story, my vibe right now. I did not use this palette, but it's, I'm very in on theme with this one. The It's Freaking Bats palette. Now, I think this is so, so unique. And again, it's very, very unique to the market. The shades that she has here, especially the mattes. Well, what I just said with the Fairy Frolic, that I could not blend the yellow and that deep purple together. Here, funnily enough, I can, because this one is brown enough. And this one, I don't know, it just works. These two also work. I can blend these together without them turning very, very muddy. And that's just so, again, so, so unique. I really like the formula of this as well. Yeah, I think it is such a fun palette. And I need to bust it out again because I really want to play with it. Then I have a palette that was PR. Also a brand that I'm affiliated with. This is an indie brand from the Netherlands, and they are called 5050 Makeup, and this is their winter palette. And the reason that I pulled the winter palette is it's a Christmas palette, but then basically Bad Santa. This is just such a dark and grungy holiday palette. I don't know. I just feel it's so, so unique. And then this shade in the center, it looks very neutral and very brown. But on me, it's more of an orange, so, or a peach. So it just, and you can use these together, by the way. It's just such a unique, again, a unique color. So I cannot wait to see what else she's going to release. I hope that she's going to be able to they almost fell. To release anything this year, because I know that she's very, very busy with her studies. So yes, the next palette was also PR. This is from Unique Beauty, and it is the Roots palette. And this was from her Africa collection. You can get the complete bundle, but you can also get the palettes individually. And this is one of the palettes of that collection. Do I need to say why it's so unique? I do, don't I? I haven't seen this before. So there is, and also there is just something between gray eyeshadow and yellow. I love that combination so, so much. A dark gray smoky eye, and then with the yellow liner and the yellow inner corner. Oh, that's just amazing. And that's what I can use this palette for if I want to. It's just so, so unique. And then also with that darker blue, it just gives it a whole new dimension. This shade here is a blue, but it also has, I'm looking in my mirror. It's a dark blue, but it also has a mint. It has purple. It's just such a unique shade. And then this yellow, it's stunning. Now, these are two flakes, and this is a very sticky dark blue. These two flakes, you treat them like they were a loose pigment. Use with a wet brush. You can with these. Yes, honestly. I did a video. Go watch the video. I got her collection in PR, so I reviewed the whole collection. I have one palette left, and this is also from a brand that is, for me at least, has very, very interesting color stories in her pressed palettes. And it is Sigil Inspired by Temi Tanuka. It's a Russian-based brand. Now, I have all her egg palettes here, the six-pan palettes. They all have some uniqueness in them. They all have a particular color story and then a pop of something that you would not necessarily pair with it, but works very, very well. The reason that I pulled this specific palette is also because of the... Yeah, this just won, because this for me is the uniquest even that I have. And it is her latest one. It's her Sand Gazelle, gentle Sand Gazelle, I believe. This is the color story. Now let's start with the mattes, which are these two, which are cool toned olive mattes without brown. These are grayer toned olives. That in itself is very, very unique. I don't have this, and I have a lot of olive shades, but all the olive shades that I have are either yellower, so warmer, or they're more neutral, or they are more brown, and these are grayer. I don't really know how to explain it. Go watch the video that I did with this, because I compare swatch the mattes to other mattes that I have in my collection. But then also this shade, when I see it, when I tilt it like that, you can kind of see it has an olive grayness as well, but it also has a pink in it. Same with this one. This is a green base. You cannot really see the green base because you see the pinker shift, but there's basically it's this shade and then with a pink added to it as well, or not really a pink, but more of a peach. And then this also has some, they're all duochromes. This shade is what makes it extra special, because this shade, when I opened up the palette, I was like, there's a bluey one in here. That's kind of wonky. And then I played with it, and it's like a magic ball sweet. It's just so, so unique, because when I use it, you see that it has kind of the purpliness. But when I used it in the last look in combination with the darkest green, maybe I can show that. Maybe I can kind of show you what is going to happen then. Let me tap it over the green. Can you see that it is completely transforming? I was like, where's the purple? Where's the blue? It was just gone, but it was so, so pretty nonetheless. It's just such a unique palette. I have more unique color stories in my collection. which is not really weird, I think. I love color. I love unique color stories, so I have more. But as I said, I made myself pick just one per brand, and I kind of stayed away a little bit from palettes that are no longer available, or at least that's what I tried. That was it for today. Let me know some of your unique color stories. If you have a channel, go do the video, because I think it will be, it's just so, so fun. It's so fun to watch everyone's collection and to hear their opinion on what they find interesting and unique. Definitely check out Beauty and the Frizz, that I will leave down below in the comment section. She's, or in the description box, she's just amazing. Go watch her video, because it's just, yeah, she's so fun. And yeah, that was it, guys. Thank you so, so much. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.